this movie, not only, Morris, are you a love interest slash romantic lead, but you and Faizon are pretty much a little comedy team there.
You know, I'm on the team. He's the comedy. You know, that's what Faizon is, the designated scene stealer. We had him come in there just to steal all the scenes. And he did what he needed to do.
Beautiful people get compliments all the time. I should know. I ain't never got one.
Very professional. This is an actor. Okay. This is an actor's actor. You learn. You know, I'm like, oh man. So we supposed to read the script?
Yeah, I still don't think he's read the script.
Seriously, you know what I want more than anything?
What?
A compliment.
A compliment?
Seriously, just a compliment.
From who?
Obviously not us.
A man, hello? A nice, normal man who doesn't have an agenda, who's not trying to hook up or get busy with me. You know, imagine this, right? I'm standing in front of a store, a guy walks by, he sees me, he doubles back and says, wow, you look really amazing. And then he leaves. And that's it.
Okay, little girl, you're next. It's your turn.
Go see Santa.
Who are you?
I'm Santa's number one elf.
More like numbers 1 through 10. Nice tights.
Hey, your mama.
And your mama, too.
Oh, there we go.
And Morris, being the suave bola guy he is, seizes the moment and gives the woman a compliment, and then hilarity slash romance ensue. Is that?
That's right. That's exactly. I couldn't have said it any better myself. What about
ensue?
You?
Ensue.
How fun was it doing the movie? Because you got Queen Latifah, Terrence Howard, Faizon does some scene stealing, but so does Charlie Murphy. It seemed like it'd be a fun movie to do.
Yeah. Oh, it definitely was fun. I think, you know, our chemistry and our just camaraderie just came through on the screen, because hanging out with this cat and, you know, Gabrielle and Charlie and Kat, you know, everyone genuinely got along. Everyone genuinely liked each other. You know, it's one of those types of movies where, you know, after you shoot a scene, you don't just run back to your trailer. You just kind of just like hang out on the set and just talk.
You know what? Look, I'm leaving. We've been sitting here like ninnies for what, an hour? And for what? I may be a housewife, but I am not that desperate. I'm leaving.
Okay. Your next one is definitely decaf.
It's crazy that we're sitting here like Starbucks stalkers are gonna name a drink after us, the crazy lady lattes.
So A Perfect Holiday was shot before this Christmas,
yes.
But do you think that coming out on the heels of this Christmas that could possibly help A Perfect Holiday at the box office?
It's just different stories. They're different stories. There's room for all of it. I don't think they have anything. I don't know. I don't think they have anything to do with it.
Not only to the degree that, you know, it's still being in theaters, that they probably have some screens that we normally would have. But, you know, I think, you know, they're both different enough in their own right to where audience will, whoever enjoyed that movie will still be able to enjoy our movie. It's not like they're the same exact movie.
Right. It's like when they release Transformers, then they release Spider-Man. The same type of thing. Action movies. White guy in a suit. And then it ensues.
Jay Jizzy is Nancy's ex-husband.
Yeah, I knew that.
Man, how come you ain't tell?
Could you ever have imagined when you first started doing this with Boys in the Hood and some of the earlier works that you did, that you'd still be working in Hollywood? Because there always seems to be a lifeline, not only for an actor or an actress, but also certainly for a black actor or a black actress. So could you have envisioned that you'd still be doing this?
You know what? No. You know, when I did that movie, I was just happy to be there, you know. And obviously, you know, I didn't realize, you know, the magnitude it would have on people. I was at the time, it wasn't like, you know, I was in a movie to where I was the lead in the movie. No one knew me. Nobody knew Cuba, you know. Ice Cube was N.W.A., but he wasn't even the front man of N.W.A., you know what I'm saying? And Fishburne, you know, he was, at the time, he had come off Pee Wee's Playhouse, you know.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So
right.
It was like,
Curtis.
Yeah, so it was just something that happened that was just special and magical. It really wasn't something where I was thinking this is going to take me to that next level. I was in a movie, didn't even know if the movie was going to come out, you know, and it just came out and did what it did. And then to think, you know, that I'd still be here to this day, I just knock on wood, you know, I'm just blessed, man, basically, you know, to have the opportunity to still be here and still be making movies. You know, a lot of people have come and gone since, you know, since I did that movie, and I'm just glad to still be here.
Excuse me, can you put this with the rest of my stuff? You are a very attractive woman.
And I'm not even gonna ask you guys a stupid question like, what would your perfect holiday be? Because I already know Faizon's, we wouldn't be able to video it.
Put it like this, it's got something to do with Beyonce.
This cat's crazy.